web of community between the isolated outposts and the larger metropolis to the south. These aerial pioneers mapped this wilderness, brought medicine to the sick, built trade and commerce, and they often worked alone, flying some of the most extreme weather in the world and without sophisticated airfields. What was his life like? To begin with, his plane was the center of his world. In the early days, it might have been an open cockpit relic of the First World War. Later, it would become a craft built and designed in this land specifically for the rigors of northern flight. He would have to begin his day with a careful pre-flight check of his craft, making sure the aircraft was ready for the journey ahead. Many pilots flew with mechanics who took on the task of nursing engines, keeping them running even when chilled to temperatures their original designers could scarcely have conceived. If he was going north, he might be transporting tools, foodstuffs, medical supplies, or anything that's made. On a return journey, his plane would be loaded with war stamps dug from the coast earned by prospectors. Or it could be packed with war belts scattered from remote track lines. In addition to cargo, he might be transporting travelers' meat.
best for airplanes. And now we're turning towards the hangar, and so I retarded the left engine throttle, and I advanced the right engine throttle, and maybe a little too quickly, and the engine didn't catch right away. So we kept turning to the right, and the wingtip of the airplane, we're doing probably 20 miles an hour, the wingtip caught the hangar wall there and spun the airplane right into the hangar. So we slid under the roof of the ring of the annex here, and the nose wheel collapsed, and we slid under the roof. The roof wiped out the whole cockpit area.
Thank you. system is a real experience. You know, you live in one day, you're up here again. And I don't think I ever went to bed anymore. You know, when you wake up. There were so many questions, you know.
First airmail for New York. And on July 9th, 1949,